Welcome back to another episode of This Week on Channel 9. I'm your host, Christina Warren, Senior Cloud Developer Advocate, and I am back from Australia. I was in Sydney, Australia last week for Microsoft Ignite, the tour, which was awesome because I got to miss the whole snowpocalypse thing happening in Seattle. Of course, I did almost get sucked into a riptide, but thanks to the Bondi Beach lifeguards and my fellow CDA, Jason Hand, I'm back and ready to bring you the latest developer news. So first up, a couple of event reminders. We've got Microsoft Ignite, the tour, taking place, and the next stop is in London. And we're about halfway through the tour, but we're still coming to more cities. So for dates and information, see the show notes and the description down below. I'm going to be at the Amsterdam and Dubai stops at the end of March, so if you see me, as always, please say hello. And in other event news, Microsoft Build 2019 will be from May 6th through the 8th, 2019, in Seattle, Washington, at the Washington State Convention Center. And this is our biggest developer-focused event of the year, and registration goes live on February 27th. And for the first time, we are also doing a call for speakers. So if you have a talk you'd like to give at Build, you have until March 16th, 2019, to submit your proposal. So see you all there, and details on Build and the registration reminder link are in the show notes and the description. And speaking of stuff to get ready for, on April 2nd, 2019 at 9 a.m. Pacific, Visual Studio 2019 will be officially released. And more than that, there will be a whole virtual event taking place online, kicked off by everyone's favorite developer, Scott Hanselman. And there's going to be a whole day full of demos and conversations centered around development with Visual Studio 2019, Azure DevOps, and GitHub. And links to the launch events, save the date, are in the show notes down below. And you can get prepared for Visual Studio 2019 by checking out the Visual Studio 2019 Preview 3 release that came out last week. Speaking of some stuff that came out last week, GitHub introduced a really great feature that I really like a lot called draft pull requests. And so the idea is that this is a type of PR that can signal if you're like not looking to merge code, but you might want to get feedback. So maybe you made a change for a hackathon or another side project, or maybe this is something that isn't finished, but you just want feedback. And so this is what a draft pull requests are for. Basically, they're styled differently to show that they're drafts and merging is blocked from them. If you do want to merge code, you just change the status to ready for review. Anyway, I love this because it's a great example of offering a feature built around how people already use GitHub. And details for how it works are linked in the show notes down below. In some Azure DevOps news, the Azure DevOps projects now supports Azure Kubernetes Service, aka AKS. And so AKS is a fully managed Kubernetes container orchestration service, and it basically simplifies deployment and operations of Kubernetes and makes it super easy to dynamically scale your app infrastructure. But you can now use AKS with Azure DevOps projects for easy CI/CD flow. And you could already deploy an app to AKS using Azure DevOps projects, but now you can deploy multiple apps to a single AKS cluster rather than having to create a new one each time. Details on how this works and links to the documentation are linked down below. So when we're talking about Kubernetes, we're invariably talking about containers. And when we say containers, we usually mean Docker. This is kind of my awkward segue into a blog series that my colleague Chris Noring started publishing this month called Docker from the Beginning. And look, there are lots of Docker tutorials and explainers out there, but what I like about this one is that Chris really focuses on what's going on behind the scenes. And the best part, no prior knowledge is required. Check out the link to his post in the show notes down below. In some Node news, my pal and Five Things co-host, John Papa, has some really great content up for using Node and Cosmos DB. And so first, he has a great video that shows how to use the NPM SDK to get a Node.js app to talk to the Cosmos DB SQL API. And then over on Microsoft Azure's Medium, he has a post that lays out everything you need for coding with Node and Cosmos DB in like 60 seconds-ish. So that's awesome. Check out both of those in the description and show notes down below. And speaking of the Azure Medium, my pal Jeremy Nalikness wrote a fantastic, huge, mammoth guide to the Azure Event Grid. And it's titled Azure Event Grid, The Whole Story. And it's a really thorough look at the serverless backbone for all your event-driven computing needs. And speaking of serverless, Michael Crump and Cecil Phillip have a great new video in the Azure Tips and Tricks video series on how to create an Azure Functions project using Visual Studio Code. Over on Channel 9 this week, there is tons of new content. So first up on DevOps Lab, Damien shows off how to use Azure Boards with GitHub. And that's really cool. And then over on Visual Studio Toolbox, Donovan is joined by Gopinath from the Azure DevOps team to look at how Azure DevOps is used to build Azure DevOps. So it's like Azure DevOps Inception, and I love it. Over on the Open Source Show, Aaron and Armon talk about open source security best practices, both for developers, contributors, and maintainers. And then over on Defrag Tools, they celebrate episode 200, a mammoth accomplishment, and there's a two-part game show. And so the contestants for this game show are Raymond Shin, Casey Limson, and Larry Osterman. And honestly, this is like the nerdiest and the coolest game show I've ever seen. It's great, especially for Microsoft fans. So congrats, Andrew and Chad, on 200 episodes. That's awesome. For .NET developers, I want to highlight Rick Strahl's post about using .NET Standard with full framework .NET. And so with all the changes coming to .NET Core 3.0, I thought that this was a really great read and explainer. And now it's time for my pick of the week. And look, warning, this is a little bit of a weird one. So my pick is actually a product that was announced at Mobile World Congress earlier this week, and it's Samsung's new Galaxy Fold phone. Okay, so it's a phone that folds out into a tablet, and it looks super cool. But you're saying, Christina, why is this your pick of the week? Isn't this a Microsoft show? Isn't this an Android device? Aren't you a diehard iPhone user? And yes, to all of those things. But in addition to being super cool, this is my pick because I cannot wait to see how the Xamarin team can address devices like this in the future. So one of the things that makes the Galaxy Fold work is that there's this idea of apps that can adapt based on whether the screen is open or closed. And you can also have three-app multitasking. And from what I've been able to ascertain, because all the documentation isn't up yet, Samsung is doing a lot of this using official Android SDKs. And so that means that it isn't inconceivable that support for something like this could come to Xamarin or other mobile frameworks. But honestly, even without all that, it's just a cool phone, even if it does cost $2,000, which means I'm never going to buy it. Anyway, let me know what you think about the Galaxy Fold, as well as all the other stories we covered this week, by leaving me a comment down below. And while you're there, go ahead and hit that like button on YouTube, and go ahead and subscribe to our channel, Microsoft Developer, so that you can get all of your nerdy Microsoft dev news every single day. See you next week.